Hey guys, what's going on? Sekka Funk. This is a mail video. All the stuff that I got in the mail. Let me get right to it. Because I haven't been privileged enough to get that extra time that I've been waiting for my videos. But this is the BK1 with Bunzilla. This is his latest EP that he's released. This is Temple to Cannibal, and if you remember this one right here, Radio to Cannibal, which is awesome album. This is an EP, and this also has some serious hip hop collaborations on it. MF Doom, and one of the tracks is produced by Exile. And I mean, I don't have to go too far into it, you know, but you guys definitely check this out. This is again Brazilian music that just so happens to be collaborated with some of rap's most unique acts out there. And they do a good job as always. And if you can see this, it's numbered 75 out of 1,000. So this is a limited number EP. And I hope it stays that way. And I'll explain that rant in a little bit. It's on colored vinyl. Let me sit in the way of the light so you guys can see. It's on colored vinyl. You know, just a simple jacket. Pretty cool though, you know. Only 1,000 of them out there. I don't know if they're sold out or not. I'm not sure. But, you know, if you guys like the Radio to Cannibal, I suggest you snatch that EP up. And the reason why I was talking about the number, if you guys remember me showing you guys this, and I said that I wasn't going to open my copy until I got another copy. Well, obviously, I got another copy, and I'm not happy. But anyway, moving on. That's Will Sessions in the background. And what I didn't tell you guys last time when I showed this album is that this is completely live, played or recorded with live instruments, sort of like how the Roots do. You know, he had a house band on this one. There's no beat machines and sample music. Well, sample music, yes, but you know, they're playing it with live instruments. The one most notably is One Love, that is the Heath Brothers Strata East recording of Smiling Billy Sweet 2. They took that, sampled it. They even freaked it even better, better than Nas did, because this is live instruments, for one. And for two, once all the rapping was over, these dudes rocked out to that same melody for like 3 minutes. And they did that on a few of these songs on this album. And you know what I didn't check? Because the digital recording has hidden tracks, like three hidden tracks. And I didn't even open this. I mean, I haven't even listened to it. That's how pissed off I was about this album. I'm about to show it to you. It has liner notes. Very cool. I wish I would have read these first, because then I could have shared that with you guys, but that's what the labels look like. So here's where I'm at, because when I got this, I pre-ordered my copy. I knew that it was a classic, a home run hitter, and these motherfuckers go and dumb it down by pressing up more copies. This was originally only 1,000 press. They decided to do more. And now I have 1,048 and 909. I'm not happy about that at all. You know, I think if you guys were gonna do this, you should have waited and pressed up a more generic package instead of dumbing down the original, man. Like, why would you do that? Like, Anyway, don't matter. This is not new. I've had this for a couple of months now, maybe a month and a half or something like that. This is Cosmic Rhyme. This is Flying Lotus, one of his most current projects. I just really like this, and I wanted to share with you guys. I wanted to let you know that there's like a mini documentary on YouTube about the artwork and the artist. Where this artwork came from. I don't remember the guy's name, but it's very, very cool. I mean, they show his studio laid out real dope, and this artwork actually came from a book that he did, I want to say back in 87. I could have the year wrong, but I mean, I would like to get my hands on that book as well. It's just a book full of illustrations, and he went through that and, you know, he paired up all the illustrations with song titles and all that. That's what the inside looks like. Very, very cool. Sorry guys, I had to pause real quick. But moving on, this next LP that I got, I've been wanting for a long time. I'm just now getting around to buying it. What I do is I save all that pictures of the albums, all the pictures of the covers of the albums that I want in a little file on my computer. And when I hit a dry spell, what I do is I go and I start buying shit. That's on my list, and this was on my list. This is Papette, or I want to say Papete. I'm pretty sure it's not Papete. It's probably Papette. He's a Brazilian percussionist, and this is on Universal Sound. This music, some of these songs do exist on an original LP, I believe it's from the 70s, or maybe late 60s, 69. He's a Brazilian percussionist. Brilliant, brilliant music. I mean, the song that made me get this is named Arda de Coco. It's on side one. It's the fourth song. Brilliant song. I mean, it's like very mellow percussion all the way up to a little bit past the midway point. They start to have this lady, and you know, if you listen to Brazilian music, everybody knows that, you know, when the lady starts singing, you're always wondering, who is that girl? Her voice is so distinct, so mellow, almost will kind of lull you to sleep almost. But this is that same intriguing female voice. This is a double LP. I definitely suggest you guys check this guy out. I will be hunting down the original. I will have to, because I feel obligated, because this music is so good. If you like percussion, Brazilian percussion, jazz, melody type stuff, then this is another one. As you guys, I don't know if you've taken note that I'm on two things right now. Vinyl eras that I'm going through is Brazilian music. And the second one, which helps me segue into this next album, is getting my damn Sun Ra on. Look, let me tell you something. When I first started collecting records, I did not like Sun Ra. I didn't care that his records were valuable. I couldn't do it. But you know what? Now that I think about it, it was really only like three songs that I listened to. It sounded all over the place, and I was just like, I don't like it. Come to find out, I've been exploring Sun Ra's catalog, and I am nowhere near finished digitally. And I am marking the albums that I like, and through my reading, they said if you want to get into Sun Ra, start with his Sleeping Beauty title. And God, man, the best advice that anybody could ever give. This album, if you guys, I don't even know what to say about it. You just got to check it out. Now, this comes in two different versions. This comes in a regular version that looks just like this. But this right here is the deluxe one, and as you can see from the sticker, 180 gram, and it's limited to 500 copies. The other one, of course, is not 180 gram, and I'm not sure if the other one has this cool inner sleeve either, with some Sun Ra photos on it. I mean, that guy took the best photos ever. Look at that. What an interesting guy. Said he was from Saturn. I know a lot of you guys out there know about Sun Ra. I know about Sun Ra. I'm no expert. This is Sun Ra and his Intergalactic Myth Science Solar Orchestra, Sleeping Beauty. Check it out, guys. I found the other ones that I like. I don't remember the names of them exactly right now off the top of my head. But, you know, my plan is to actually get one of the unique originals of this album. It's probably going to cost me a couple hundred to $300. But, you know, to me it would be worth it, because, first of all, if you don't know about Sun Ra, his albums, most of his albums anyway, on his private Saturn label were one of a kind. Some of them were hand-drawn with markers, some of them didn't have labels at all. Which, actually, let me show you this. Keeping in the Sun Ra fashion, check out what this the LP looks like. No label. That's how he did his thing, man. So, that's definitely a recommendation. I have listened to it. I haven't listened to it on vinyl. I can't wait to experience on the 180 gram vinyl. That's something I definitely looking forward to, and I'm gonna do that as soon as possible. This next album, you know, I don't want to not recommend anybody's music. Let me not do that. This next album was disappointing. This is a CSC funk band. Things are getting too casual. Now, funk is where my heart is. I love funk, but this right here, there's nothing special about this, if you ask me. This, I fit into the trend that's going on right now. It has been going on for like the last five to six years, and that is a whole bunch of people getting together, mainly for some reason. The New York scene has a lot of them. It's just percussionists and brass guys that know how to play their instruments, and oh, we're gonna play funk. But to me, that's not funk. If you compare this to the funk that was played back in the day, this is a novelty. Real talk. It is. I mean, first of all, there's no lyrics, I don't think. I couldn't even get through the whole thing. It just sounded so run-of-the-mill to me. I mean, yeah, you're playing funk music, but so what? You don't dress funky. I mean, just because you don't groom your hair or whatever, I mean, that doesn't make you funky. But I mean, funk is more than music. I mean, just look at the Parliament. Look how those guys stepped out on stage. This, to me, is nothing. These are nothing but guys that book dates and go around to all the little small New York venues and play their novelty, run-of-the-mill funk music. They didn't nail it. If I don't like it, I don't like it. It doesn't mean that I'm hating. I'm just telling you like it is. I'm not saying don't go out and buy it. I bought it. And I bought it knowing that. I just decided, let me just get the vinyl anyway. Maybe they'll go on to become a little bit more polished and do better things. But, I mean, as of right now, this title is, I mean, this to me, if this came out back in the day, it probably wouldn't even be radio filler, to be honest with you. Because it's not believable. That's it. That's it on the head. That's the nail on the head. It's not believable. Check it out. Listen for yourself. I listen to a lot of funk to be able to say that too. I know it's funky. I'm not saying that I'm the only one, because I'm pretty sure everybody else who knows it's funky would agree. I don't know if I have enough time to talk about this, but this album right here is considered rap jazz. It's a 3-LP album. 1, 2, 3. Die cut sleeve, as you can see. This is the Herbalizer Take London. The reason why I got this is because it has Jean Grey on it. And one of the few female record rap artists that I respect. I don't know how much I can say about this. I have like a minute and a half to do it. You guys, this is classic. And it's not new. I'm just getting around to getting it. I told you I was in a dry spell. And now everything's starting to roll in. These are two blokes from England. And it's rap jazz, you know. The rapping to me is okay. But there's enough. On the 3 LPs that's in here, there's enough instrumental, just true to form, good music on this that made me want to get this. And it's not expensive, and it's a must have. So this is Take London, the Herbalizer, you guys. And that's all I have as far as mail day. I got some stuff, some flea market finds that I'll share with you guys in my next video. Take it easy.